verse 20. Then the gods gave individually to her their respective weapons. The wielder of Pinaka gave to her the trident, drawing it out of his trident. The 21. The dark god also gave the discus, whirling it forth from his own discus. Varuna gave her the conch, Agni the lance. 22 and 23. Vayu gave her a bow and a pair of quivers filled with arrows. Indra, the thousand-eyed, lord of the gods, gave her the thunderbolt, taking it out of his thunderbolt, and the bell from his elephant, Airavata. Yama gave a cudgel out of his cudgel of death, and the lord of waters the noose. 24. Brahma, the lord of beings, gave her the rosary of beads and the water pot. Surya placed his own rays on all the pores of her skin. 25-27. Kala gave her a sword and a spotless shield. The milky ocean gave her an unsullied garland, a pair of unaging garments, a brilliant crest jewel, a pair of ear pendants, bangles, a luminous half-moon ornament, bracelets in all arms, a pair of shining anklets, likewise a necklace, and bejeweled rings on all the fingers. 28. Vishwakarma gave her a brilliant axe, missiles of various forms, as well as unbreakable armor. 29. The ocean gave her an unfading lotus garland to wear on the head, another one to wear on the breast, and a very beautiful lotus to be held in her hand. 30. Himavan gave her the lion as the vehicle and various gems. The lord of wealth gave her a drinking cup always full of wine. 31. The king of all serpents, Shesha, who bears this world, gave her a snake garland bedecked with huge jewels. 32. Honored with ornaments and weapons by the other remaining gods as well, the goddess roared with laughter again and again. Starting with 20, going to 32. Shulam shulad vinishkrsya dadau tasya pinakadrut chakram chadattavan krishna samutpadya pachakratah shunkham chavaruna shaktim dadau tasya hutakshanah Maruto dattavams chapam bana purnetate shuti vajramindra samutpatya kulisha damara dipaha dadau tasya sahasraksho kanta maravata jagat kala dandadyamo dandam Pasham chambupatir dadau prajapatischak chamalam dadau brahma kamandalam samastaroma kupesh nijarashmin divakraha kalascha dattavan katkam tasyas charmacha nirmalam chirotascha malamhara Majare chattatambare chutamanim tata divyam kundale katakanich ardachandram tata shubhram Yuran Sarva Bahushu Nuprau Vimalau Tadvat Rave Yakamanuttamam Anguli Yakratnani Samasta Swanguli Shucha Vishvakarma Dadau Tasya Parashum Chati Nirmalam Astranyane Karupani Tata Bhityam Chadamshanam Amlana Pankajam Malam Shiras Yurasi Chapram Adadajalatistasya Pankajam Chatishobhanam Himavan Bahanam Simham Ratnani Vividani Chit Dadavashunyam Suraya Panapatram Danadipaha Sheshascha Sarvana Gesho Mahamannibhibhushitam Nagaharam Dadau Tasya Tate Yaprithivimimam Anyarapi Surar Devi Bhushana Rajyudhaistata Sammanita Nanadochai Sataha Sammuhur Muhu Tasya Nadena Gorena Krishna Mapuritam Nabaha. So picking up at verse 32 in the English part, the English translation. I think you can see that book, but anyway.
Okay.
At 33, the entire sky was filled up with her immeasurable, stupendous, terrible roar, and great was the echo that arose. All the worlds were agitated, and the oceans raged. The earth quaked, and all the mountains rocked. 35, victory to thee, exclaimed the gods in joy to her, mounted on the lion, and the sages lauded her, their bodies bowed in devotion. Seeing the entire triple world agitated, the enemies of the immortals marshaled all their forces and rose up with weapons lifted. 37. Ah, what is this? Exclaimed Mahishasura in wrath and rushed towards that sound, surrounded by all the asuras. 38-39. Then, when he saw the goddess pervading the three worlds with her effulgence, let me start that again.